Hello everyone. Today in this video we are going to learn chapter number 2, that is noun function. I hope that you understand the first chapter noun, which is related to this second chapter. Okay, so in the first chapter we learn about noun, we learn about the types of noun. Okay, we learn about the different categories of noun, possessive form of noun, gender of noun, then after singular, plural, that is countable and uncountable noun. So we learned the very basic thing of noun, which you already know, right? But here also noun function also, if you know also, then it is good for you. If you forgot the terms a little bit, then we can do it again. Okay, so in this second chapter we will learn about the different function of noun. Okay, noun is a naming word. It is a naming word. This is a definition of a noun. Okay, it is a definition of a noun. That is, a noun is a name of a person, place, animal or thing, or like that. Okay, object, emotions, ideas, this all. But how does it function in a subject? How does it work in a particular sentence? So that we are going to learn in this chapter. Okay, this one is already done. You can do it by your own and then you can check the answer with my one. Try, this is very very fun. That is, it is jumble words. Okay, now here what is given: a noun may be placed as a subject of a sentence, okay, as a direct or indirect object of the verb, or as an object of the preposition. So these are the functions it plays. Okay, noun plays as a subject, as an object. Object can be of two types, direct and indirect, and it can be work as an object of the preposition. So we will go through this topic individually. So first of all, we will learn noun as subject. How does it work as subject? So basically we know that noun is work as a subject. Okay, in each and every sentence there are two parts. There are two parts in each subject, a sentence. Sentence contains two parts, that is subject and predicate. This we know. Yeah, when we learn about sentence, okay, then this is the basic and the common thing which is given at the starting of the chapter, that sentence is made up of two form, subject and the predicate. And subject is noun. Subject is noun, or it can be a pronoun. Okay, but now we are talking about noun, so we will learn about noun. Okay, so we all know that subject is noun or pronoun. So noun, we just leave about pronoun. Let's find out about noun. What kind of subject, what kind of noun can be there for subject? So see here, the part of the subject that tells who or what the sentence is about is called the subject. So subject, what does it tells you about the sentence? That who or what the person, or who or what the sentence is. The sentence is talking about what. Okay, so subject basically tells you that who or what the sentence is. So the subject of a sentence may be one word noun. It can be a one word noun, it can be a compound subject, or it can be a noun phrase with a head noun. So let's see in the example which is given about all these three things. Okay, so what is given? That the subject of a sentence may be of a one word noun. Snakes can slither up a tree. This is one word noun. Snake, we are talking about whom? We are talking about snake. So snake is a subject. And see here, snakes, it is one word noun. Okay, so subject can be of one word noun. What about compound subject? Okay, compound we will come later. First noun phrase. We're talking about noun phrase in the second one. A skillful and intelligent carpenter makes good furniture. Main noun is here carpenter. This is a main noun, okay? A skillful and intelligent carpenter. This is a noun phrase. So a noun phrase is a group of words that act as a noun in the sentence. Group of words. So noun phrase is not only a single noun, it is a group of words. So here how many words are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is a noun phrase. Okay, group of words. Okay, then after, men and women cooked a meal together. So this is compound subject. Compound subject is made up of two subject. So two subject is, one is men another is woman, and it is joined by a coordinating conjunction. Here the coordinating conjunction is and. It can be or, it can be anything, and or, like that. So man and woman cooked a meal together. So man and woman is a compound subject. So just keep in mind that subject. Now we are going to a broad concept, okay? Yeah, we are learning a little bit of broad concept about the subject. The subject can be a one word subject, subject can be a noun phrase like this, subject can be a compound subject, okay? Okay, let's solve number A, and the same thing whatever we learned in the previous page So about that is given here. What you have to do, that underline the subject in these sentence. You have to underline the subject. Five ducks waddled across the road. Now, so here the subject is five ducks. The Shatabdi Express chugged along slowly in the heavy log. What is the subject? The Shatabdi Express. The earliest people used to hunt for food in the forest. What is the subject here? The earliest people. This oil has a magical effect on hair. So here, which is the subject? This oil. Okay. So these are the subjects. So very easy. You do the rest of the six by your own. Okay. Now let's move to the next topic, that is noun as direct object. So I told that noun work as object, and object are of two types, direct and indirect. So let me tell you that object are of two type. First one is direct, another is indirect. Okay, direct object and indirect. So first of all, we will learn about direct object, and later on we will learn about indirect. Okay, now see here in your book what is given. Sometime the subject may be the doer of the action conveyed by the verb in a sentence. Okay, now what is doer of the action? The doer of the action is the person or any animal performing the action. That is the doer, means the performer. The another meaning of doer is performer, the person who performs the action. Okay, so here the subject may be the doer of the action conveyed by the verb, so which is affected by the verb. In many cases, the action performed by the subject, sometime when the action is performed by the subject, it affect or is received by some another person, another noun or pronoun followed by the verb, and that noun or pronoun are called direct object. Why? Because they directly affected by the action. Okay, if you have not understood, let me give you one example. Okay, here my mother gives a pen. Okay, here my mother is a subject, and what she is doing, she gives something. She gives to whom? She gives to she gives a pen. Okay, my mother gives, what she give? She give a pen. So her action affecting someone. Okay, it affecting whom? It affecting a pen, which is a noun, not a pronoun. So a pen is a direct object. Okay, keep this in mind. My mother gives a pen. So my mother is a subject. She is performing something. What she is performing? She is giving something. What she is giving? She is giving a pen. So the action affect a pen. Okay, and the pen is direct object. And see, the direct object is a noun, means it is object. So noun perform as a subject, which you learn, noun perform as a object. So this is the object. Okay, let's see some example which is given in your book. I called a carpenter to make furniture. I performed a function. What is the action I perform? I called. To whom I called? I called a carpenter. So my action received by someone, that is by a carpenter. Yes. Okay. So a carpenter is a head noun. A carpenter is a object. Okay. Direct object. So this is also work. This is a noun. Okay. A carpenter makes furniture. Now again, a carpenter is making something. What he is making? A furniture. Okay. So he is doing an action, that is making, and but to whom it affect furniture. So see, furniture is a noun. So these all are object. So noun can be work as a object, as an object. Men and women cooked it together. Men and women cooked. What they cooked? They cooked it. Okay. So it is a pronoun. Okay. It is a pronoun. So it is the direct object. So it is the direct object. Okay. So this is, in this way, noun work as direct object. So don't only think that I, a carpenter, men and women only are noun. Noun are a carpenter also, noun are here a furniture also, noun are here, noun, it's not, it is not noun, it is pronoun, so leave it about it. Okay, understood? So noun work as subject also, noun work as object also. Here also subject, here also object. Now let's do number B, which is very easy. Underline the verb and circle the direct object. You have to underline the verb. Here the verb is this one. The underlined are the verb. In this way you have to do. Girish always visit his grandparent over the weekend. So Girish always visit is verb. Whom he visit? His grandparents. So this is the direct object, which is a noun. Raghav and Shirin have bought a new house. Bought is a verb. But they bought a new house. A new house is direct object, which is a noun. Mohan takes his herd of sheep to the pasture every day. Takes is verb. And what is the direct object? His herd of sheep, which is a noun. The principal congratulated the football team on their victory. Congratulated is a verb. Okay, whom they congratulated? The football team. This is a direct object and this is a noun. So in this way, do the rest of the six. Okay, till today, this much. Later in the next video, we will learn about the rest, that is indirect object and other topics. Thank you.